come loose.
If so, just whack it back in place and I'll get this junk burning.
Right. Give me a sec.
Thank you. If Saul freezes to death, it will have been a wasted day.
Okay. Let's go out with this. Taking damage. It feels like I'm taking damage. And it sounds like I'm taking damage as well.
See what I see? Expiration date's from before the last war, so hopefully it hasn't turned to poison. Today's our lucky day.
Lucky? Interesting choice of words.
Do I hear a lecture coming on? Go on, get off your feet. It could be ours.
No, no lecture. But we do need to talk. That raid's crap. It shouldn't have happened. They wanted everything. Our camp locations, routes, offloading points. But they knew what state we're in. One or two more raids and that'd be the end of us. And if you hadn't mounted a raid of your own, well...
It's not the time for this. We're both exhausted.
Maybe you're right.
We can't hope to handle the Raffens alone.
So you would sell us out to Biotechnica? Vade, tell him it's a damn rotten idea.
You gotta agree with Pan Am. Sounds like a truly shitty idea.
Thanks.
What could you possibly know about it?
Remember the backers?
I'm a bit hazy.
Exactly. Joined up with the Snake Nation, then poof. Evaporated. Aldecaldo's strength has always been their independence. Give that up, my clan's fate will be yours, or worse. Because Biotechnica just ain't Snake Nation.
Thank you, V. I could not have said it better.
We've had our spats.
A few, like any family.
They're not worth digging up.
I think so, too.
If you'd like to come back, everyone will be waiting. Arms open wide. There will have to be changes. No more jumping to the front of the line.
And so it begins.
You know what, sweetheart? We'll have plenty of time to tear at each other's throats later.
That is my hope.
But right now, I wouldn't mind catching a few winks.
Need help?
Fuck off. Huh. Do you know what they call these storms in North Africa? Boobs. Damn, I love that word.
This has the words, boobs in it. Good animation right there.
Well, what was that about?
Probably the meds talking.
I sure hope so. I think he took a few solid hits to his skull. Funny.
What is?
I rarely sleep with a roof overhead. Yet this will be the second time with you. When you're on the road, day into night, today, your butt basically fusing with your seat. Forget what it's like.
And? Think this is any better?
No, just different. Yeah, this would make for a decent little motel, wouldn't it? A little fireplace, booze. Grumpy guy at reception is the one thing missing.
Have everything you need, man.
Mm-hmm. I couldn't ask for more.
Ma'am, I'm sure you'd be cozier with your shoes off.
After a full day in them, I fear a health code violation.
Nonsense. After a day as full as today, you deserve to kick back.
Oh? And what did you have in mind?
Got a few ideas. Think you know what kind?
No. It's really as is. Let's not spoil it, okay?
I'm sorry. I know what I was thinking.
No, it's fine. Truly. Don't let it worry you.
Ah.
Right.
Not fair.
So, friends, then.
B, I'm glad you came. Really. Thanks.
Oh, my pride!
It meant a lot to me.
Oh.
Do you hear that?
Guess I messed that up.
No.
The wind has waned.
I can't speak for her boobs, but when a Chinook rolls rough and rowdy across the plate...
Derp!
Oh? And what did you have in mind?
Here at the Independent California, customer satisfaction is job one. Your wish is our command.
Careful. You can't know what I'd wish for.
Mm-hmm.
You know what? We better get some sleep. That was a damn long day. B, I'm glad you came. Really. Thanks. It meant a lot to me.
And regardless of whatever option I choose,
do you hear that?
I'm in the friend zone.
No.
The wind has waned.
I can't speak for her boobs, but when a Chinook rolls rough and rowdy across the plate, I sure can't get any shut eye.
Not awake.
On behalf of the staff of the Independent California Motel, I wish you all sweet dreams.
She's gone.
Style raid.
Is all doing all right?
Cracked skull, 6 busted ribs, bruised kidneys, but he's back at it, bossing folk every which way. You?
You gotta agree now. Next time, I choose the motel.
If there is such a time. Well, I slept like a puppy. That's a cozy shoulder you have there. Too bad I better get rolling in a minute.
Just not one to kick back and relax, are you?
It's not my style, no. I'm back with the clan, sure. But I have things to do. Come on. Last night, when we were talking to Saul, thanks for standing up for me. Though, one thing. The Wraiths, the raid. It's the start of something we need to prepare for. Saul will get everything set up in camp. Whereas you... The Raffins wanted to know our roots, right? Well, it's the Aldecaldo's turn. Some recon is in order. One more thing. Your compensation. Please take care of her. She served me well.
Sniper. When am I supposed to grab this?
Putting her in good hands, Panam.
I know. So, thank you. Once again.
Hold up. About last night.
We don't need to talk about that. I'm just not like that.
So what are you like?
More. more like this.
Uh-oh.
Take care of yourself.
You too, Pan Am.
I definitely fucked
that up. Remember,
out.
I'm indebted.
Circumstances were different, I'd say saddle up and ride after her. But here and now, just look. Damn hard to catch a girl like that. Only hope you've got is they feel a pang and stop to wait.
What's with you?
Dunno, a memory maybe. Don't matter. Okay, back to town, V. Headed up to here with this gusty outback.
Oh, I messed up on that. Is this another ride I got? Or? Yeah, I definitely think I fucked that one up. Unless if there's still more to this.
V, oh, do you have a moment?
Need to talk?
I mean a longer moment. Can you come by the camp? I have a problem.
On my way.
Phew, thanks. That's good to hear.
Give me a little more intel. What's your grief?
Well, it would be better to...
Let me guess. Saul, right?
You know me well.
Uh-huh. See you soon.
That's what I was waiting for. Okay, that'll be fun at the time, though. Like, am I even going to be able to romance this chick? I'm laughing. I'm focusing more on a romancing branch or quest or whatever than just the main quest. Well, I mean, it's nice to get immersed a little bit. I guess that'll be for another time, though. Because I think I'm going to stop right here for now and continue another time as usual. Alright then.
Later.
Well, time to continue from where I last left off then. So I might as well just try to finish this chain of quests then. Might as well. Just out of curiosity. I can't really act like I haven't really done like in-game romances and shit like that. Can either be funny to watch or just it's just some dumb little fantasy.
I forbade you from even breathing on that Militech convoy, so you call in your friend? To do it all behind my back? Is that it?
Uh-huh. That's exactly why I had V come and stand right in front of you. Do you think I'm that stupid?
I am starting to wonder.
Damn it to hell, Saul. Are you seriously considering letting that basilisk slip through our fingers?
I am.
But a chance like this?
A chance of what? Rotting up the job we came here to do?
Get the sense this fight's grown stale. Come on. Put some feeling into it.
No. This discussion ended long ago. The Biotechnica people will be here in an hour. Try not to cock anything else up before then.
Cock anything else up? What do you mean, fuck? Anything else
I can't believe it. Look, there he goes, off to paint the grass green.
What's this basilisk nonsense?
It's an armored Militech cargo panzer. Junk from back in 2060 or so. They want to peddle it off to a backwards country, somewhere it can still pass as a technological wonder.
The Militech convoy will take the 101 right past us. Shame not to say hello.
Is this basilisk worth another fight with Saul?
Yes, a craft like that would finally put us back on the right path.
The family is falling apart. If we fall into this Biotechnica rut, no one will ever take us seriously again.
Okay. So you do want to go behind Saul's back. You drag me here specifically for that.
Cassidy, Ted, Carol, and Bob, also on board.
Okay. Everybody told me to give you a good pick in the pants.
And you plan to grab the basilisk how?
Thanks, V.
Haven't said I'd help just yet.
Okay, let's go talk to the rest.
So, just the four vets on board with the plan. Nobody else?
We didn't bother asking the others.
There was too great a risk someone would take it to Saul.
Besides, only the vets understand what we have to gain by having a basilisk.
Sounds pretty risky to me.
On the contrary, easy as pie. There won't even be much security on the convoy. Plus, we'll be doing our part towards furthering the cause of world peace. Why should this beast wind up being used in some little third world skirmish? We'll make better use of it right here in America.
Did you try to get Saul on board again? No luck, huh?
No. Okay, everyone listen. Militech will transport the basilisk in parts distributed across two trucks.
Wait, do I sense a quiver in your voice?
Fuck you! The convoy will halt at the railroad crossing on the 101. We'll attack from behind, then get the hell out and away. Questions? Comments? Motions?
Nice job, Sunshine.
Mm-hmm. Damn short, sweet, and pertinent. None of that.
Okay, I'm in.
Okay. Thanks. First, we'll ride to the station. The train engine we need to block the convoy's way is there. Are you riding with us, or will we meet you there?
I'm
riding with you.
Excellent. Let's get going.
I think I heard a little shake in that voice.
You did not.
Ah, come on. Did you get your hands clammy, too?
Screw you.
But are you sure you didn't leave any tracks? Militech won't notice a thing.
Are you trying to insult me, Bobby?
Okay, okay. Forget I even asked.
Nobody's gonna notice you gone back at camp?
Saul has no wish to see us there anyway. The better to make a good second impression on the Biotechnica suits.
Your sour faces wouldn't help much.
Indeed, they would not.
Might as well always sound like that.
Raffins, what about them? Expecting any trouble?
Saul is. He's posted sentries all around the camp.
How's that not right?
He's wrong in continuing to fight the symptoms rather than the disease.
You don't miss life in Night City?
At times, perhaps. I miss the feeling of having a new beginning. Of freedom. But I also haven't forgotten the emptiness. The feeling of realizing it means nothing if you're alone.
Had a hard time leaving my family, too. I was never completely alone, either.
Had someone?
A true friend. Jackie by name. You would have liked him, actually.
Jackie. I remember that.
Hopefully they'll make that drink after him as well. Not that they already did. I guess this is the mission right here.
We have arrived.
Okay. Let's see if I can skip the ride.
Big bastard.
I like it so much, maybe we should just hijack the train. Let the basilisk go on its way.
Yeah, then just drive this beast to the 101. There and back.
Saul would be on board with that.
Are we ready? Okay. The Militech convoy will be traveling from Night City to the base where they're due to meet the buyer. We will stop it at the railroad crossing.
All we have to do is shove this beauty in its way.
V, any questions?
Plan to move this thing how exactly?
It's old tech. Carol will have to hack it.
Then I'll somehow have to finagle authorization from the control tower to move it.
Tower looks inactive to me too.
Yeah, we'll see to that. You and Pan Am just get the authorization code.
Okay, let's get to work.
Area. definitely raised my tech level.
Look, that was quick.
Well, it's a tech level or as well as technical prowess, whatever you call it. It's an ability to access tech. Or
there it is, then.
Huh.
I've always been fond of trains. And the stations where so many tracks converge.
Junctions.
Yes, those. When you see them from above, you feel...
free. Like you could set off on 1,000 journeys all at once.
Perhaps more simply, hopeful. Okay, here we are.
Sure thing.
Punch cards. Things?
Nothing here. Nada. Nothing here.
Except for health.
Well, well, well.
I guess I found it.
Got something. Goes nothing.
It worked. Come look.
Little engine that could.
V, I wanted to speak with you.
But...
you want to talk about?
I know this may sound foolish, because I asked you to help me, but why are you doing this?
Let's go with this one.
Because it's important to you.
But is that all? Sorry, that sounded worse than I intended. Listen, V, I'm sorry. I'm not very good at this. Speaking of my feelings and so forth. And I would not want to cock this up.
Cock this up.
Well, that's a start.
The thing is, I usually act before I think.
Uh-huh. Noticed.
I know. But I also need impulses to act upon. When I do something spontaneously, I feel I'm being honest. Yet with you... prefer to play it safe.
Don't feel any impulse one way or another.
Why is it any different with me?
Because I truly care this time. Yet I fear I'll do or say something foolish and be left alone in the desert. I would rather keep you close. If only as a friend.
Try following the impulse next time.
Okay. Well, in any case, you've been warned. All right. Let's rejoin the others.
Did I even do that right? I'm gonna laugh if I did all this for nothing.
Convoy. Got eyes and ears on it?
Yes. Carol checks their communication channels from time to time. Everything is proceeding as planned.
I'd have to do all that all over again.
Now.
She did say friends, so she might have just put me in the friend zone. I picked the wrong dialogue choice if I wanted to do that. do that whole romance thing.
We could still
sit your ass down a minute, honey. Breathe.
Everything's under control. The convoy is already heading our way.
Up and wait then.
You're acting spooked. As if you're the first person ever to stand up to Saul.
Oh, save your breath. I don't need to be consoled. Was it someone I know?
New. Scorpion.
You came home from the war? Head full of new ideas and a host of new contacts. He tried to get Saul to lead us in joining Snake Nation. It would make us stronger, he said.
I don't think he peeped a word of it to me. What did Saul do?
Saul dressed the guy down head to toe for messing with the family. Hell, he didn't send him on any jobs for a year.
Gee, really consoling. Thanks.
You said yourself you didn't need any.
Ought to raise a glass to Scorpion.
And to Jack.
To Scorpion.
Some sleep.
Okay, it'll be quite some time before the convoy comes through.
Going kind of cold out here.
Not true, but this is nice.
Catch some shut-eye with me.
I'll just lie here a while, by your side, gazing at the stars.
Is that another area of your expertise? You got maps of the heavens in your library too?
Of course. That's the Big Dipper. And do you see the small flickering star to the right?
The stars.
Yeah.
You do? Oh dear. That means there's a major leak. Good night, B.
thought I was gonna get rejected after that.
Okay, here they come.
Is everyone ready? Let's ride, V.
Still needs patches. Jeez. Oh, yeah, definitely.
All right. She's moving.
Get her up to speed.
PS5.
Okay, let's go. Ready to roll.
Didn't think I'd get to see those barely rendered faces on this I'm just gonna play through right now.
Fuck! It worked! Woohoo!
Of course it did! Just as I said it would!
Reinforcements? No.
How's it going there, V? Did you have fun?
Sure did.
Just be happy you won't be around to put the hunk of junk together. The real fun is just starting with Mitch and Teddy.
Could be some upshot dialogue. That's hooked when she looked out of her car. Clipped to it mostly. Did some.
Fuck! Pan Am!
So it begins.
What's the meaning of this?
Exactly what you see. The Basilisk.
All I see is two trucks with giant Militech logos on them. Pan Am, you can see them from miles away! You think we don't have problems enough on our hands? The Raffens could rear their heads at any moment! And now we have Militech to worry about, too!
Stop it! Fuck! Just shut up already! Do you want to serve corporations forever? Fine, go right ahead! In that case, we'll leave the Basilisk as a souvenir of what this family used to be! Or you know what? Maybe next time we're attacked, we'll be able to fight back!
As soon as I'm done with Biotechnica, we call a family meeting to discuss this. Discuss you. Until that time, I want these trucks out of my sight.
And the Basilisk? Can we put it together?
Do what you want. Just get out of my sight.
Bob, Mitch, you two take the trucks around back. We need to unload.
Sure, but then what do we do with them?
Oh, I've got an idea.
Got quite a pair of lungs there.
Thanks. I believe the last time I pulled something like that, I was 10 years old.
Seems to still be in fine working order. Everything okay?
Yes, of course. Though the great train robbery bit of this was much more enjoyable.
You need me again, all you gotta do is call.
V. I'm sure I will. So you better expect that call.
You wait. Take care.
Right there. Our vehicle so I can get out of here. Oh, did it crash?
Ribbon.
B. Hey. I need your help.
Sounds like it. What happened?
I shouldn't talk about this on the hall, though. We gotta meet.
When and where? Tell me.
Glenn, tonight. I'll flick you the details. Will you make it?
Do my best.
Thanks, V. Till then.
I must have got another mission right there. Guess I'll go to the camp.
V, the Basilisk. It's ready. Would you like to drive it?
Sure. Be there soon.
Fuck me. It is awesome.
Now I hear.
Hello, V.
Jefferson?
Listen, I need your help again. Matters private.
Sure. Okay. What's it about?
Not on the hollow. Come by. I'll lay it out. Explain everything.
Got your back, Jefferson. Not to worry.
Great. We'll see you here then. Remember where?
Of course. Be there in no time.
Just a little more time.
All ready to go?
Hey, V. No, not yet.
Carol still needs to check if Militech left any ice in the systems.
Corvos haven't shown up in person to report the loss?
No, I think we managed to keep them off our scent.
We left the trucks with the big Corpo logos down by the wrapping kit. Which was almost as much fun as leaving a bag of flaming dog shit on their doorstep.
Fuck, made it look like it just came back from a Corpo war tour. Nice touch.
Everything's fine. Clean as a whistle.
I always wanted to take one of these suckers for a spin.
Which is exactly how all those naive gonks landed at the front. Didn't even need to be recruited. They just showed you the tech.
Come on, hop in. Everything is set.
Just got in.
That ace.
One more look at that is.
Damn it.
Anybody get this thing up and running earlier? Maybe you
Everything
oughta.
Everything is dandy. Give me a moment. Not the latest model, but Mitch and Bob did what they could. What do you think?
Nice and cozy in here.
You steer directly from your seat. All you have to do is jack in.
What, no knobs, buttons, blinky doodads?
No, none. The impulse runs directly to your cerebral cortex. In a sense, the basilisk becomes an extension of your body. It's like a mystical oneness.
Ever piloted anything like this?
No. Why? Don't you trust me?
Can I still get out?
No.
Then I trust you. If it's so mystical and shit, why the co-pilot? Extra support?
I'll tell you once we're a bit further from camp. We'll practice. You want full functionality in an engagement. You need a second person to handle sensory overload. One pilot steers, the other handles the gun. It's oddly pleasant. You'll see.
Two pilots?
You won't be steering and firing. Are you ready?
Pan Am, is this, as designed?
Neural synchronization doesn't happen at the snap of one's fingers. It'll be over soon. There, see?
Hey, I don't understand what you meant.
a few turns. All right, I can see you've grown bored. Now take her along the line of turbines. When I say so, swerve right or left before the last of them.
All right. On the menu.
Don't get excited. The Basilisk is a cargo ship by design. But it should still be a good time. All right, blast those wrecks. Better than dirt. Good. Bullseye. Okay, practice is over.
What's happening?
Hijacked in. Our nervous systems are now linked.
Right. Basilisk pilots working in harmony. Is that why I'm feeling everything doubled?
It's sensory feedback. Our systems are intertwined. Would you like to try it out?
Okay. I could go for that. Honestly, no idea how people focus on combat.
It's probably not always this intense. How about this?
Still naked. naked. Oh, yeah. Or in his boxers, not naked. Or the left, still naked. For Pono.
If I have to leave the clan, please just say so. Spare me another speech of yours at the very least.
I'm afraid you'll have to sit through a few more. Because from this day forward, you will lead this family by my side.
I will what?
I wish to do this properly, but fine. Have it your way. I was wrong. You were right. That's the truth. May it never happen again.
But I made a mess of so many things. You said...
I know. But I changed my mind. You risked everything for this family, not even knowing whether you'd be welcome the next day.
Okay. Okay. Well, many things will have to change.
Yes, and to start with, we need to leave this place, quickly. We can't wait for Militech to find us.
Of course. I will prepare our route.
Close my phone.
Congratulations.
Terrible choice. I voted nay.
Thank you. Thanks. I need to cool down, I think. Will you come with me? An interesting day. I feel as if I barely evaded a rapidly approaching train.
It's pretty close.
I don't know if I could have done it without you.
Hey, come on.
No, I'm serious. We all owe you. So you can count on me all the countless. Always.
Good to know.
You're so good.
Nobody's behind the bar. That I like. Beer? Lemonade?
Beer me.
To happy endings.
What now, boss?
I have no idea. I'm serious. Not the faintest.
Turns out Saul's all right. So, it's all wrong?
I'll play it by ear. V, look around. Look at them. They could be your family.
Pan Am, what are you...
Stay in camp. Join us.
It's really not that simple.
You either want to or not. What's so complicated?
That's the problem. What I want right now doesn't mean a thing.
All right, V. I shouldn't drop bombs like that on you right now. I just thought... forget about it.
I'll think it all over.
Relax. Everything is okay. How do you feel?
What happened? I remember. We were talking. Then, suddenly...
You passed out. Completely. We took you with us.
Where?
Somewhere new. We moved camp. Don't worry, we are safe here. For now.
Oh.
V, you have to tell me what is happening. The blood. You were out for hours. What's wrong?
Pan Am, It's getting...
getting worse. Every single day.
Okay, B, relax. Take it bit by bit. What is happening? Exactly.
Okay, so... you ever hear of the relic?
The Arasaka tech? The something with personalities? I saw the ads. Sounds like some rich people scam, to be honest.
It's not bullshit. I've got a biochip in my head with one of those constructs. And the chip's damaged.
So take it out!
Definitely not that simple. Relics also keep me alive, but...
So this is cyberpsychosis? Because if it is, I know people who...
No. The chip's data is affecting my neural connections. Got nothing to do with cyberpsychosis. I remove the relic, I die. If I don't deal with the construct, I die.
Fuck.
Just trying to live with it. Survive, actually.
It's certainly not doing wonders for your health.
I gotta go. I'm feeling better, really.
Wait, I will go with you.
I thought I heard that voice.
Hey, Mitch. Finally. We were worried.
Took good care of your ride. She's over there. But you're not leaving us already, are you?
Is everything okay? Thanks. I'll stick around for a bit.
Make yourself at home.
Remember, our offer still stands. If you need help, the Aldecaldos are here for you.
And that, at least, we can agree on.
If you need anything, you know where to find us.
Want me to walk with you?
Safe here, though.
For now, yes. Militech does not venture this far. And our vantage points really are much better.
Welcome back to the land of the living.
But you know, everything here, it is temporary. All of it. We will soon have to decide what comes next. V, back to what we were saying. I will not even pretend to understand. I don't think it has even sunk in yet. But I am serious. How can I help?
Honestly, not a clue.
But there has to be something. Someone who can...
Remember Hellman? He's the one who created the personality construct tech.
That's why you wanted to get him.
A dead end. Now I have to figure out where to go next.
You'll find a way. And once you do, let me know. I will help. This whole family will help. Saul was not joking. You understand?
Thanks for everything. For being here for me.
Take care of yourself.